Today's video is about a hidden feature in Excel's advanced filter that I never knew about. I found out about this last week. It came packaged nicely as an email and video from Brian. Now, I know Brian quite well, so when I read this sentence, I knew there's something good in there. It was better than I thought. Of course, we're going to share it with you. What I want you to do is this. Watch this super short video and let me know in the comments below if you knew advanced filter could do this or not. Type a yes or type a no if you didn't know. Let's jump in. First off, let's refresh our memory on what the advanced filter feature does, and then I'm going to show you the trick. So here I have a small data set that goes over 100 rows. I collect information on company, customer, article, quantity, and sales in USD. What I want to do is filter this data set based on specific criteria, and I want to copy it to another tab, the results tab. Now, the criteria that I want to use in this example is that article description should include the word laptop, and that dates should be greater than or equal to July 1st. Since I'm going to be using advanced filter for this, I'm going to add my criteria separately on the side here. Now, you might want to add it to a separate tab, that you have a query tab. You keep that separate to your data set, but for the purpose of keeping things simple in this video, I'm going to add them right here. To make sure I have the exact same spelling, I'm going to copy and paste my criteria here. So the first one was that date should be greater or equal to July 1st. My second criteria is that article description should include the word laptop. So I'm going to use wildcards here. Start off with the asterisk sign, type in laptop, and add the asterisk sign after that. Now, in this data set, I think laptop always occurs at the beginning of the article description. So in theory, I don't need the asterisk sign in front, but just in case I have an article that has the word laptop in the middle or in the end, I'm going to add the asterisk sign to make sure those lines are also included in my results. Okay, and if you have more criteria you want to add, just copy the header, put it on the side, and add in your criteria here. Since I want to have my results copied to another tab, I need to start from that tab. Okay, so always start using advanced filter from the place you want to have your results in. Then go to the data tab, click on advanced. For action, we want to copy to another location. List range is our original data set. Make sure you also include the headers, then control shift down to include the whole data set. Criteria range is the criteria that we just defined. It's also sitting on the data tab right here on top. Make sure you include the headers. Where do we want to copy it to? To the results tab in cell A1 and click on OK, and that's my filtered list. If you've been using advanced filter before, this is not new for you. Now, here's what you might not have known, and it's something that I didn't know before. I always assumed that every time you use advanced filter and you're copying your original data set to another location, you copy every single header. Basically, you copy the entire data set, you just filter it based on the criteria that we want, just like we did here. But what if we didn't want the entire data set back? What if we just wanted specific columns and columns that didn't even include our criteria? So let's say we just wanted to have the sales document number back and the quantity and sales USD. So I'm just going to copy the headers that I want back and paste them here. Now, here's what you need to do. Go back to advanced filter, so data advanced. Repeat the same steps that we did before. So copy to another location. List range is the same. That's our original data set. The criteria range, nothing changes there. That's also the original criteria that we had defined here. Now, this is where we have a slight difference.
don't click on an empty cell, but instead highlight the headers that you want back. And Excel filters the dataset, but only returns the headers that you want. And that's the filter trick that I discovered from Brian. Now let's just cross-check the data and compare it to our original filtered list just to make sure it's identical. These are the exact same document dates, same quantities, same USD, except we don't need to get all the results returned. We just get back what we want.
Many thanks to Brian for sharing this hidden advanced filter option with us. Hit that thumbs up if you enjoyed it. If you want to learn more about Excel's filter feature, check out the links below. Don't forget to subscribe to get updates, and I'll see you in the next video.